I hope this lecture or this teaching isn't leaving you a little bored, quiet again today. Apostle Cooper, do you mind reading our first chapter on page 8? Our first paragraph, pardon me. Yes, ma'am.
Consecration. The word consecration means to set apart for sacred purposes. My heart and mindset must be. My life belongs to God for His purposes, to fulfill the call of God. God is holy, so also is the call of God. Therefore, the servant of the Lord must maintain a holy lifestyle, which is a part of consecration.
So I can drink like I used to. I can smoke like I used to. I can't cuss and hop out and hang out all times of night like I used to. I can't wear my skirt way up yonder like I used to. That's just the women folk. They get by the men folk. You mean to tell me I can't have a second one? Just take the first one. Ain't acting right.
I live.
I said drink like that. You. Watch it, Apostle. Like I used to. But I didn't tell me I can't drink.
Oh my.
I love it. I love it. But we have those excuses. In our Bible study, there's a young lady by the name of Kwanda. IBC knows about Kwanda. That's why they're laughing. Kwanda. Kwanda asks the question that nobody else wants to ask. Amen? Kwanda is the one that's actually the devil's advocate. You mean to tell me, when so-and-so told me to get off that pew, I had to move child, I ain't studying her. That's Kwanda. But that's not godly. So, you, in your growing up, in your teaching, and you understand, man of God, you said not everybody went through the church, but I believe the majority of us have. But not even in that, just in your upbringing with your parents. They say when you go to the folk house, you don't touch nothing, you sit down, you be quiet. We go to Zaire's, I remember Zaire's, I'm trying to tell us something about myself. That before became Ames and okay, Walmart. So now, you people over there, I always wanted to ride a pony that was outside of Acres and yeah. I always wanted, you ain't got no quarter of dollars. You can't do what everybody else is doing. It's not clean, it's germ. I didn't understand that. I didn't understand that it was tainted. Somebody could have sneezed, coughed, did whatever they wanted to do. Grandma didn't have no alcohol to wipe it down.
Right.
It always a Bible accessible to you. You holy and clean.
That's right.
Not always a preacher around to tell you, don't do that. But if the word has been planted in you of how to live, how to consecrate yourself, how to allow yourself to be set aside, that is a part of your calling. That's a part of your living. Amen? There are some scriptures here that will continue to exalt that concentration. Going down to the bottom of the page, the Apostle Paul, in fulfillment of the Lord's word, for I will show him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake. And Paul speaks of some of his suffering in the mentioned chapters. So when you begin to give up the things of the flesh, when you begin to really, really, truly move towards the mark and your calling, you have to let some things go.
Right.
Even some people.
That's right.
Right.
Yes.
When they don't want to adhere to the rules of the gospel of God, right, sometimes you just got to let it go.
Yes.
Now, I'm not saying go home and say, she said, get out of my house. You have to give a person the opportunity to fail or make the decision that this is not the life they want to live. But you have to make the decision if you will still be in association. Now, bringing division from that association does not mean you take away your love. Doesn't mean when you see me, I see you, I know you, you go on this side, and I go on that side. That's not what it means. And I'm staying with her because she got to deal with her. No, I can't be a part of it for the sake of God. For the sake of my calling. And people understand. They do. You may not feel like they understand that, but they do. Now, that being said, the word tells us that when God is on the scene, the devil has to do what?
Yeah.